Hey there, I am Asysel, and today we are going to get you started with your T-Scan Hub 2. In this Getting Started, we will be teaching you a first common scanning strategy. Feel free to pause at any point to follow along. There are also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started! In the previous Getting Started video, we showed you how to use the system in Common Spect and do a first scan. But as highlighted next to the workflow assistant, we have implemented a remote workflow to easily guide you through different tasks by using the buttons on the back side of the scanner. Once the scanner is initialized, you can start the scan project at any time by hitting the left or right button on the back side of the scanner. The software changes into full screen, focusing on the scan process, and everything that is not needed gets hidden. To make it easy, we have created some standard templates which help you to fulfill your tasks. Notice that you can also make your own templates if you have other reoccurring scanning tasks. We want to scan this part from one side, so we have placed some reference points on it. Then choose the template you would like to use with the buttons on the back of the scanner. You can also change the point spacing if needed. This defines the detail that we want for this part. Before you start scanning, you should actually capture the reference points, because this will increase the accuracy of your final scan by collecting reference points up front on the part by using the function Capture Reference Points. We will use this function due to the size of this part. As I do not want the table to be scanned, I place two additional cards on the table. This will ensure the software recognizes it as the background and doesn't collect any scan data from this area. In the next step of the workflow, the software can now automatically create a clipping plane of the table. Everything that is underneath that plane won't get scanned. Hence, we only create a scan data of the part and ignore everything else that we don't want to scan, like the table. That speeds up the workflow as less scan points need to get processed. Okay, let's continue. I can start scanning with the hit of the trigger button on the front side of the sensor. In the software, you immediately see all the scanning data being collected, and you also immediately have a feeling for what you've scanned and what you are still missing. So at any time, I can pause the scan, maybe rotate the part around and continue scanning. Thanks to the distance radar, we also know how to orientate the scanner to the part. You see that I only collect data on the part and not the data on the table. As I mentioned, there is no need to clean up the mesh afterwards. As the T-Scan Hawk 2 has a large field of view, it makes it easy and fast to scan a big part at once, and we need to stick less reference points. You probably also have seen that we are using smaller reference points compared to our previous system, thereby covering less of the component. All right, as you might have noticed, this part also has deep pockets, cylinders that go all the way through the part. For normal scanning, these areas are sometimes difficult to reach, and therefore we have a specific scanning mode with one laser line to be able to reach deeper into pockets. So if I pause scanning, I can switch and use the blue single laser line to be able to go deeper inside the pocket. This makes it easier to scan in hard-to-reach areas. All right, I have scanned this complete part and its deep pockets. So the last thing we need to do is to polygonize this raw scan data, because the polygonization will make sure that we will end up with one mesh result. One final digital copy of your part. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or if you have any issues with your T-Scan Hawk 2, please reach out to us via support at hansometrology.com. For more Getting Started information, please check out our other videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.